So, right now I'm going to change over from summer oil to winter oil. Briggs and Stratton twin cylinder 24 horsepower platinum engine. I believe you can only get the platinum engines in Canada. They were Sears models. I'm not exactly sure what line of Briggs it is in the United States. But it's so far so good. I have done absolutely nothing to it besides change the oil. It has close to 300 hours on it. Ten years old, 2011 model. I'm not sure when I started using it in the winter as well. After the summer was over mowing lawns, I used SAE 30 oil in it from Canadian Tire, whatever brand was there. And when I started using it in the winter, I switched to, I believe it was 5W30, just normal oil, and then I heard Briggs suggested putting synthetic, so I believe I've been putting synthetic in it for the last 4, maybe 5 years. In the summer, I put 10W30 synthetic, and in the winter, 5W30 synthetic. And she doesn't smoke, she's got a lot of power. Operate a snow blower in the winter. Heavy wet snow, and she barely bogs down. So, simple oil change coming up. I tend to use Mobil 1, but I'll use whatever's on sale. I'm not really partial. I hear good things about Mobil 1, so I use it. Try to buy it when it's on sale, but if I need oil and it's not on sale, I buy whatever is available. Sorry about the camera work. I'd like to know where all this, if anybody could tell me in the comments where all this dust comes from. I guess it's just chewed up grass, or I don't know, it seems to hang around the motor. Is it like bypass? I have no idea. But it gets everywhere. So if you know in the comments what all this dust is, especially like down at the bottom there, like is it bypass from the gaskets? Like it around when I go around the filter, there's a lot around that too. But anyway, I ran the motor for about 5 minutes, heat it up, try to get it a little hot to get rid of the fluids, but I do like these oil changes, no tools except for maybe a filter wrench to get the filter off. It's pretty pretty good. I have to do my 2020 Toyota Corolla, and that's a little more involved. You have to take off a skid plate, and well, that'll still be the first time doing that. It's being done by Toyota, since new, because I bought an extended warranty, so they cover some oil changes, which I'm not happy about, but we'll talk about that on the video. Just let that drain out. And you don't need to watch oil drain, so I'll pause it. While the oil's draining, I'll come over to the filter side and clean that up a bit. Pretty much done draining. Hard to do with this one hand. I guess you gotta I guess I should have taken the dipstick out first. Get some air behind it, but I forgot. That's okay. This is always the messy part. It's too bad they couldn't put these filters facing up so that when you unscrew them, nothing comes or very little comes out. Oh, yep. She's on too tight for the hands. I guess if you do this every day, you'd know which way to go or which way to put this on, but yeah, I always get it backwards. Reposition the oil pan so that I can get the filter every time makes a mess. I guess one good thing, it preserves the metal here, like practically factory new here. A little windy. Just clean where the gasket goes. Make sure there's no old gasket on there. And for an oil filter, I just use these Laser brand. I don't know who makes them. But they're the tall ones. They seem to be pretty good quality. Never cut one open, but they're made in China. But it is just a lawnmower. As somebody says, this ain't the space shuttle. Although, it is an engine and does require filtration. But they do put a plastic seal over the opening, which is nice. Down, you can't see any rust or anything. You can see the bypass valve in there. Looks pretty good. Gasket comes out pretty easily, but I've never had one stick onto the engine. This winter it'll get some Castrol Edge 5W30, stronger under pressure, titanium technology. Put a little in there and put some over the, on the gasket to lubricate the gasket. And it says three quarters to one turn after the gasket hits. So there's the gasket hitting. And not even close to that. I may turn it like a half a turn after the gasket hits. There. New filter on. We will pour in the oil. This particular one takes 64 ounces, around 2 liters. I believe is this the rest of whatever's in here, but They put those little clear slits in the bottle that you're supposed to read the oil. But you can't read the oil. And at least I can't. It's quite a bit of it. I'll let that sit for a minute. I will take off the glove. Still below the add mark. Still a little bit below. You gotta remember too, before you start it, there's no oil in the oil filter, which has a certain capacity. So it's above the low oil mark, so we will start it up, check for leaks, and then wait a couple minutes and measure it again. There, of course, there's not going to be. And there is something leaking from the oil filter, so let's clean that up and have a look. This will be a first time ever. I don't know if it was blow by or what was left there, but we will have a look. Might be just I didn't clean around the oil filter good enough, and the vibrations were making the oil seem like it was flowing. I'll try to clean it up better. And then we'll try it again. Can't see any oil, but we'll try this again. No oil this time, so I just didn't clean it good enough, I guess. Wait a couple seconds and check the oil on the dipstick. Should spray all the connections. Check the oil again here. Hard to tell with new oil. Yeah, it's under the ad mark. Pretty sure there's 2 liters left in this. But I'm just gonna dump it all in. not filling the bubble on the full mark, but it's right there. So didn't fill the bubble on the full mark, but it is right below it, so we'll call that an oil change. And that's all I have.